Ozempic was approved as a diabetes treatment 7 years ago. And according to the latest Oklahoma Diabetes Prevention Report, more than 390,000 adult Oklahomans suffer from diabetes, about 13% of our adult population. Capitol correspondent Jason Doyle joins us now with more on Diabetes Awareness Day at the Capitol this week. Jason.
Rich, that breaks down to 1 in 8 adults with either type 1 or type 2 diabetes. It's estimated that more than 18,000 adults are diagnosed with a chronic illness in our state each year, meaning it's a way of life for many Oklahomans.
There's a strap in there.
Okay.
Can I get that strap? I don't have one on the base.
It's Sunday afternoon and time for Taylor Young and his Limp Wizards bandmates to practice for their next show. No matter how good band practice goes, Young has to make sure he stays on top of his blood sugar because he has type 1 diabetes.
Usually I have a sensor, but not having insurance right now.
If you don't have insurance and you're a type 1 diabetic, I mean, minimum cost you're looking at out of pocket would probably be around $1,200 to $1,500 a month, and that's just to stay alive. That's not to really get the best treatment you can get.
Currently, Young has just changed jobs and waiting for his new insurance to kick in, so he's not worried right now. But a few years ago, he was struggling just to afford the cost of staying alive. He'd like to see lawmakers take action to help those who don't have insurance to better afford things like insulin.
I would definitely support it, but I've realized in some states, they've passed laws that cap the price of insulin, which it's kind of like clickbait because people see that and they're like, they're doing a good job, but what they don't include is a lot of times that's only capping the price for people with insurance.
That's something Senator Carrie Hicks would like to see the legislature take upon itself.
A couple years ago, we were able to cap the out-of-pocket cost for folks with health insurance. But unfortunately, if you are without health insurance, and Oklahoma's number one in folks without health insurance, you're subjected to the list price, which can be $250 to $300 for just a vial of insulin.
Yeah, how much money do you think is in here?
I don't know. I have no. That'd be a lot of money.
Yeah, one of these vials of Novolog. There's a few other brands in here, but they're, for all intents and purposes, are the same thing. One of these retails over the counter, without insurance, for about $365.
Young has about 50 empty vials in the bag, meaning he spent more than $18,000 to fill it. Each vial of insulin lasts Young about 3 weeks. For those who can't afford their insulin because of a lack of insurance, the Health Alliance for the Uninsured can help connect them with resources.
As many people know, we have a very high rate of uninsured individuals, and the free clinics are sometimes the only option for individuals to get care. And we provide services like specialty care referrals for free surgeries, imaging, things like that, medication assistance, and navigation, helping people get connected to free clinics.
Janine Jones is the executive director for the Alliance. She notes quite a few Oklahomans are using the free clinics.
And we find that in our free clinics, probably 70 to 80% of the patients are being treated for diabetic conditions. So it's a huge need.
Jones and her organization were at the Capitol on Monday to take part of the Legislative Diabetes Advocacy Day. Senator Carrie Hicks is the co-chair of the Diabetes Legislative Caucus, which put on the event.
So this is the first time that we've had a Legislative Diabetes Advocacy Day. At least in the last 10 years, we've been trying to piece together the history.
It is well known that Oklahoma ranks in the top 10 of states for diabetes. But what is not so well known? The difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Type 1 is an autoimmune disorder which makes a person dependent on an outside source of insulin. It's often referred to as juvenile diabetes.
Type 2 is a resistance to insulin. And so either through lifestyle, behavior, different things like that, your body kind of develops a reluctance to being able to process the own insulin that your body is producing. And so type 2 diabetes can progress to a position where you would need insulin administered as well to stay healthy and stay alive.
Obesity can serve as a precursor for type 2 diabetes. In Oklahoma, more than half of all new cases of type 2 diabetes are related to obesity. The Centers for Disease Control estimates more than 1 million Oklahomans may be pre-diabetic. Jana Comer was on the verge and pre-diabetic until she took action.
My high weight was 300 pounds, and for a 5'2"
woman, that's too much. And yeah, I was getting close to diabetes and I had joint problems, liver issues, and all those kinds of things.
She's now an advocate with the nonprofit organization called Take Off Pounds Sensibly, or TOPS. They help connect people who are looking to change the course of their lives by changing their eating habits. She says avoiding diabetes through diet does not mean you have to have kale for every meal.
What we do, we eat sensibly. I ate more of the foods that are healthy for me, that I like, and less of the foods that are less healthy for me, but I still eat all of the foods that I like. And I like all the foods I eat.
Taylor Young is looking forward to when his insurance kicks in because he'll be able to track his blood sugar levels a little more closely.
I'll have my CGM, my continuous glucose monitor, back, and it's just something I wear on my arm, and it connects to my phone, and I can see my blood sugar at all times.
And that can keep Young and the rest of his band rocking on.
Diabetes is a costly chronic disease, costing Oklahomans $2.8 billion in direct medical expenses a year. Rich?
Jason, thank you.